إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد تفسير was reported on the authority of Uqbah ibn Amir al-Juhani رضي الله عنه وأرضاه collected by Imam al-Hafiz ibn Abd al-Barr رحمه الله تعالى in Jami al-Bayan العلم فضله that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم he said هلاك أمتي في الكتاب واللبن that the destruction of my nation is found in al-kitab wal-laban. It is found in the book and in milk. It is found in the book and in milk. This is something that is tremendous, ayyuha al-Muslim. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he informed that from the pernicious nature of the shaitan, the evil nature of the nafs and the shaitan, that the two things that are from the most benefit for mankind of the affair of the deen and the affair of the dunya, which is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and something that is beneficial, that is a shifa, as is found in the statements of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as a cure, which is milk, that the destruction of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would rest therein. They said, Ya Rasulullah, wa mal kitabu wa al-laban? They said, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do you mean by al-kitab wa al-laban? What do you mean by the book and milk? That the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be destroyed by the book, meaning the Quran, and by milk, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in his hadith, وَهُوَ حَدِيثٌ حَسَنٌ in his authentic hadith, حَسَّنُهُ الْأَلْبَانِيُ رَحِمُهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى greater to be authentic by a Shaykh al-Allama, Muhammad ibn Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, رَحِمُهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى in سُلْسِلَةِ الْحَدِيثُ الصَّحِيحَ the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يَقْرَؤُونَ الْقُرْآنَ He said that people recite the book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala فَيَتَأَوَّلُونَهُ عَلَى غَيْرِ مَا أَنزَلَهُ اللَّهُ The people recite the Qur'an and they will interpret it in a way other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it for. The people will apply the Qur'an where it doesn't apply. And the people will understand the book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala with an understanding that was not the understanding. It was not the meaning of Allah and the meaning of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the understanding of the early generations of Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, along these lines, he said, "Inna minkum man yuqatil ala ta'wilihi kama qataltu ana ala tanzilihi." He said that amongst the ummah, in another hadith, he said, "Amongst this nation will be those who fight over the meaning of the Quran." Just as I had to fight over the revelation of the Qur'an. Meaning that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the revelation of the Qur'an to the Quraysh, they fought against him. Alayhi salatu wasalam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informed that there will be from this nation those who will fight the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and fight the people of khair, fight the people who are upon the methodology of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, generation after generation over the meaning of the Book of Allah. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. Ayyuha al-Muslim, the Imam of the Salaf, from the scholars of Basra, Abu al-Aliya, Rufay ibn Mihran, al-Riyahi rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, may Allah have mercy upon him. He said, ta'allam al-Qur'an, kama ja'a bihi Jibreel ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khamsan khamsan. He said, learn the Qur'an as it was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and brought by the angel Jibril, khamsan khamsan, five verses at a time. Five verses at a time, as is reported from Uthman and others, that they would not allow a person to memorize 10 ayah from the book of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala until they had memorized what they contained of meaning and what they necessitated of action from the person. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informed that the Muslims would fight each other over the understanding of the book of Allah. تبارك وتعالى أن يسترتكم على البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك that I left you upon pure brightness. His night is like his day. No one strays from this brightness except that he is destroyed. Except that he is destroyed. Meaning no one strays from the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he meaning no one strays from the alfaz and the ma'ani of the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The words of Allah and the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the meaning of those words as was understood by the early generations of Islam. Except that they will be destroyed. Except that they will be destroyed. Ayyuhal Muslim. And so for this reason we find that in the history of Islam, as Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said in his book, As-Sawa'iq al-Mursala, al-Jahmiya wal-Mu'attila, he said that there has never been a fitna, there has never been a trial in the history of Islam, illa kana sababuha al-ta'wil, except that the reason for that trial was a ta'wil al-batil, was the people misinterpreting the book of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. The scholars, they mention, as is mentioned by Ash-Shatibi rahimahullah ta'ala, in al-Muwaffaqat, in his book Al-Ihtisam rather, the reasons why people deviated, the reasons why people came to misunderstandings as regards the meanings of what is in the book of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. He said that the reasons for al-ihdath al-deen, people introducing new understandings into the religion, that they are three. The first is al-jahl, the first is ignorance. The first is ignorance, and ignorance is no'an, and ignorance is of two types, he said. Is ignorance of al-masail or al-wasail and ignorance of al-maqasid. Ignorance of, what is called ulum al-ala. Ignorance of the Arabic language itself. Ignorance of al-nahu wa-sarf. Ignorance of the sciences of the Arabic language. As was stated by the Imams of the Salaf, they said, inna min al-ujmati utitum, that you people have been destroyed because of an inability to understand and speak the Arabic language. And some of them said, أَهْلَكَتْكُمُ الْعُجْمَةِ, that you have been destroyed by al-ujma, by your being non-Arabs and not understanding the Arabic language. This is reported by Umar and al-Hasan al-Basri and others. Also from al-jahl, also from ignorance, is the people being ignorant of al-maqasid, any of the goals of the sharia of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the goals and the objectives of Islam. What Allah tabarak wa ta'ala revealed the sharia to safeguard as regards the beliefs of the people and the worship of the people and how they do business with one another and the likes of those affairs that will safeguard them in this world and the hereafter from chaos and destruction and so on and so forth. Likewise, from the causes of al-ihdath fid-deen, of people introducing things into the religion, the scholars they say is ihsan al-dhan bil-aql, the people overestimating the role of the intellect. The people overestimating the role of the intellect. And he's thinking that they are smarter than they are. Thinking that they are more intelligent than they are. Likewise, from the causes of al-ihdath al-deen, the scholars they mention, from the causes of introducing things into the religion of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, that are not from the religion of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, they said, is it tiba'ul hawa? Is a person following his desires? A person following his desires. All of this, it goes back to one thing, which is al-jahl. The danger and the pernicious nature of being ignorant about your religion. A day should not pass in the life of a Muslim, except that he increases the knowledge about Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, knowledge about the hereafter, that affects his heart, that causes him to fear Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, going back to the hadith, he said, وَأَمَّا الْلَبَنِ, he said, and as for milk, and how milk will be a cause of the destruction of my nation. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يَتْرُكُونَ الْجَمَعَاتِ وَالْجُمَعِ, that the people will abandon الْجَمَعَاتِ وَالْجُمَعِ, praying the congregational prayers and the Friday prayers, وَيَبْدُونَ, meaning that they will pursue the dunya. They will pursue, he mentioned milk as an example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that people will pursue the dunya and they will abandon praying the jama'ah with the Muslims, praying in congregation with the Muslims, and they will abandon the Salat in Jama'ah, or the Salat al-Jum'ah, with the Muslims, وَيَبْدُونَ, and they will move to the Badiyah, and they will move to the Badiyah, they will move to the outskirts of the cities, they will move far away from the Muslim community. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said another authentic hadith, he said, مَنْ بَدَى جَفَى, that the person who moves outside of the cities, جَفَى, and then he will become from the people of al-Jafa, from the people of al-Jafa, from the people of al-Qaswa, wal-Ghidha wal-Fadada, from the people of harshness and abrasiveness. And the person will become apathetic to the concerns of the community. A person will become uncaring about other people, about his community, about those people that are around him. He doesn't care about the guidance. guidance of the creation. He doesn't care about the guidance of the kuffar. He doesn't care about the guidance of his brothers and the welfare of his brothers. He is not from those people that are outadul masajid, that are from the pillars of the masjid. They are those people that are fastened to the masjid. Those people who have a love for guidance for themselves, a love for guidance for others, and a love for the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to reach themselves and to reach others. There are those people about whom the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ لِلْمَسَاجِدِ أَوْتَادَ, that indeed the masajid has awtad. Indeed there are stakes in the masjid. Yani poles that are nailed into the ground, meaning people, the ruwad al-masajid, that are umar al-masajid, people that frequent the masajid, and that are stuck to the masjid, meaning in their spare time, when they are not attending to the rights of their family and earning a livelihood and so on and so forth, they find themselves in the house of Allah. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. Inna lil masajidi awtada. They are stuck to the masjid like a pole that holds up a tennis nailed to the ground. Inna lil masajidi awtada. Al malaikatu julasa'uhum. An authentic hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, indeed the masajid has awtad. It has these people that are like poles that are nailed into the ground. The malaika congregate with them. In ghabu yaftaqidunahum. When they are absent from the masjid, the angels go looking for them. Wa in maridu aduhum. And if they are ill, the angels visit them when they are ill. Wa in kanu fi hajatin anuhum. And if they have a need, the angels attend to their need. If they have a need, the angels help them with their need. وَجَلِيسُ الْمَسْجِدْ عَلَى ثَلَاثِ خِصَالٍ. And the person who sits in the masjid will benefit from one of three things or all of three things. أَخِي مُسْتَفَادٍ. He will find a brother that he can be of a benefit for. Somebody that he can teach some beneficial knowledge to. Somebody who has a need that he can attend to. Somebody who has a need that requires that somebody looks after. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said another authentic hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لِأَنْ أَمْشِي مَا أَخِي الْمُسْلِمِ فِي حَاجَةٍ حَتَّى أَقْضِيَهَا لَهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنَ نَعْتَكِفَ فِي هَذَا الْمَسْجِدِ شَهْرًا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith graded to be authentic by al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala in al-Jami al-Saghir, he said that I walk alongside my Muslim brother attending to a need of his until I make sure that he has fulfilled his need. It's more beloved to me than making i'tikaf in my masjid for an entire month. It is more beloved to me than making i'tikaf in my masjid for an entire month. But the person who was, as the other hadith says, men bada jafa, that the person who moves to the outskirts, who moves far away from the masajid of the people of the sunnah, who moves far away from the salafiyin, who moves far away from the places where he will learn his religion and congregate with his brothers, man bada jafa, the person who moves far away, who lives far away from the Muslims, he will find himself in a state of jafa. He will find himself in a state where he is apathetic, where he has apathy towards his brothers, where he doesn't care about his brothers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, جَلِيسُ الْمَسْجِدْ عَلَى ثَلَاثِ خِصَالٍ. He has three traits, three things that he will benefit from by sitting in the masjid. أَخِي مُسْتَفَادٍ. The first being a brother that he can be of a benefit for. By coming to the masjid, he knows his brothers. He knows the names of his brothers. He knows the needs of his brothers. The concerns of his brothers. The worries of his brothers. The scholars, they say that when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, نَهَا عَنْ تَشْبِيكَ الْأَصْحَابِ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he forbade a person even when walking to the masjid or sitting for the salat in the masjid, let alone inside of the salat, to interlace their fingers together. To interlace their fingers together. They said that the reason for this is that the person who has a need, the person who is in a dire situation, the person who interlaces his fingers, it shows that he is worried. It shows that he is sad. When he comes to the house of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, if he has a haja, before asking his brothers, he raises his hands in dua and ask Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, at the time of the answering of the answering of the dua between the adhanain, between the adhan and the iqamah, they ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala an yarfa anhu al-bala, to raise affliction and calamity and hardship from him. And then he takes the means. And if he needs help, then he is not too proud to ask for help. As some of the scholars, they mention about the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ثَلَاثَة, there are three people, لَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِمْ وَلَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ. There are three people that Allah will not speak to on the Day of Judgment, and He will not look at them with mercy, and He will not purify them before the Day of Judgment, and before being purged in the fire from their sins. And they will have a horrible punishment. He said, وَمِنْهُمْ الْعَائِرُ الْمَسْفُوءُ الْعَائِرُ الْمَسْفُوءُ إِيَ الْفَقِيرَ الْمُسْتَكْبِرُ The person who is mutakabbir, mustakbir, who is poor. Some of the scholars, they explain the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning the person who is too proud to ask for help. A person who is too proud to ask for help. First he has to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. مَنْ لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ غَضْبَانْ كَمَا ثَبَتَ عَنَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ Because a person, as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, who does not ask Allah, then Allah is angry with him. And Allah is angry with him. But if he has a need, and the only way he can get his need is by giving his brothers the opportunity to increase in their closeness to Allah, تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى And to increase in their affection and the love that they have for one another. Because all they have after Allah is themselves. And they are in bilal al-kufr, in the land of disbelief, the hal al-ghurba, in a situation of strangeness. Where they have accepted Islam and their families have shunned them. They have accepted Islam and even their children may not want to speak to them. They have accepted Islam and the sunnah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the manhaj of the Salaf al-Salih. And they find themselves in an extreme state of strangeness. And if they do not help one another, then who will help them after Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He said, هُوَ الَّذِي أَيَّدَكَ بِنَصْرِهِ وَبِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ That is He, the Most High, who aided you with His... هُوَ الَّذِي أَيَّدَكَ بِنَصْرِهِ With His help and His support, وَبِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah sent His support, Allah sent His help, and He sent the believers, and He gave you the believers, He helped you to the believers, not even the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could do it by himself. Not even the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was free of need of anyone else. Even the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was helped by Allah through the believers. But the people, they become cold, they become apathetic, they only see each other on Jummah or a couple of times throughout the week. They barely know each other, they don't know the names of the children of one another, they don't visit one another, they don't have al ukhuwatu sadiqah.
They don't have a true brotherhood towards one another.
Their
rukhuwah is
muzayyafah. And it is a fake, disingenuous brotherhood that they have between one another. It is a brotherhood that is like an Imam Fudayl
ibn Iyad from the Imams of Mecca
and the Tabi'een. He said, may Allah have mercy upon him about some of the people in his time that the relationship between one another and then the ukhuwah between one another, it was like a piece of khashab. It was like a piece of wood that had gold paint over it. It was like a piece of wood. It was a knockoff. It was a forgery. It was a counterfeit brotherhood that did not have genuineness to it. He said that about people in his time. Before 200 years had passed from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that about some people in his time. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the people were abandoned because of their pursuit of this world.
Because of their pursuit of
al-rafahiyah, of enjoyment and pomp and glitter of this life. They will abandon the jama'ah. The jama'ah of the salat that is designed to bring them together. And the jum'ah, both of them coming from the word of jama'ah, that which brings them together.
They will abandon the salat
and the masjid. And they will
abandon the jum'ah, way of doon.
And they will move out
to the outskirts.
They say, our brothers, ha'ula'i masakeen, look at these brothers, they are poor. Look at these brothers, they are poor. Don't you know that the first to follow every prophet and messenger were the fuqara? They say the brothers, their masjid is fi mantiqa khatira, and it's in a dangerous neighborhood. The masjid is in a place I really don't want to go, I don't want to think about anymore, because Allah blessed me with the rays of work so I was able to move out to the sticks with the Joneses. And so I don't want to even think about my brothers anymore. I don't want to see my brothers anymore. I don't want to have to come inside of the city to sit in a masjid. I want to sit in a $14 million masjid, enjoying the air conditioning while they're sweating over there.
I don't want to see my
brothers. I don't want to sit in the durus. I don't want to sit in the classes. I don't want to call my brothers.
What are you doing, woman?
Better Jaffa. And they move far out. They move to the outskirts. And the person who was like that, Jaffa. And the person who was like that, he becomes apathetic. He stops caring about his brothers. He stops being concerned about his brothers. Wallahu musta'an. والله المستعان. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, al-bada'u min al-jafa' wal-jafa'u fi al-nar. That al-bada', that being any profane in your speech, and he being abrasive and mean and cruel in your speech, that it is from jafa, that it is from this dryness, it is from this cruelty that comes about by the people moving to the outskirts, by the people not caring about their brothers, by the people not visiting their brothers, by the people not having a true connection with one another. He said that al-bada'u min al-jafa, that this behavior comes from al-jafa. This abrasiveness, this harshness, this profanity in the speech, it comes from al-jafa. It comes from being apathetic. It comes from apathy. Wal-jafa'u fil-nar. And apathy is in the hellfire. And apathy is in the hellfire. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he said, al-arabu ashaddu kufran wa nifaqa wa ajjaru an la ya'lamu hududa ma anzala Allahu ala rasulihi. That the Arab, that the Bedouins, those people who live in the outskirts, those rough around the edge people, those people who had no concern for their brothers. He said, "Ashadu kufran wa nifaqa." They are the worst of people in disbelief and the worst of people in hypocrisy. Speaking about those people in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam who lived in the outskirts. Those people in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then what did he say? What is the reason for that? Wa ajdaru alla ya'lamu. And they are the most likely of people not to know the boundaries of what Allah sent down upon His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning because they are juhal, because they are ignorant people. They are people who are not learning the creed of Islam. They are not learning how to worship Allah properly. They are not learning the character of the Salaf. They are not learning the history of Islam. They don't know anything about the legacy that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam left His Ummah with. They're causing to build an enormous civilization that stretched from the borders of China to the west of Africa within 100 years of the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Where the people, white, black,
Arab, Persian, no matter what they were brothers with one another.
That time, in the time of the Tabi'een, where you had the 11
Imams of the Sunnah, that were the
greatest Imams of the Sunnah, that were the students of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 10 out of 11
of them were freed slaves.
There's a civilization where these people came into Islam.
Their fathers were
war captives. They have fought against the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they received such good treatment as prisoners of war
that they embraced the religion of Allah
tabaraka wa ta'ala, and they were treated in such a way
and educated in such a way
that by the second generation, the children of the free slaves stood upon the minbars. They stood upon the pulpit.
Because of the love they have
on another. The person who goes to the masjid, he's going to find a brother he can be of a benefit for. Or he's going to find a word of wisdom, something from the Book of Allah, the Son of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that which is a conformity to it. Or he will find rahmah muntadara. He will find the mercy that he is anticipating from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad. الحمد لله وحده وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه سلم تسليما كثيرا. Was reported by Imam al-Araka'i رحمه الله تعالى from Thabit ibn Ajlan. The narrator, his name is Baqiyat ibn Walid. He said, on one occasion Thabit ibn Ajlan, he said to me, he said, I met Anas ibn Malik. And then he went on to mention the names of over 20 scholars of the Sunnah from the first and second generation of Islam. He said, I met Anas ibn Malik, and I met Muhammad ibn Sirin, and I met Sa'id ibn Musayyib, and I met Sa'id ibn Jubair, and I met Hassan al-Basri, and I met, and he mentioned the names of the scholars of Basra, some of the scholars of Kufa, some of the scholars of Medina, some of the scholars of Mecca. He said, I met them all. He said, I met them all. He said, كلهم يأمرونني في الجماعة. And every last scholar from the Salaf, every last scholar from the Sahaba and the Tabi'een, يَأْمُرُونَنِي فِي الْجَمَعَةِ. They ordered me as regards the Jama'ah. What is meant by the Jama'ah? They ordered me as regards the congregational prayer. They ordered me as regards al-Jama'ah, being unified with the Muslims as regards their creed and their ideology. And as regards having the belief, the creed of the Salaf, that which is mudawwan, and there are entire voluminous encyclopedias of creed that have been written by the Imams of the Salaf, and enormous books that brought us the statements of the people of innovation and the refutation of their statements, and every time the people who introduce belief systems into Islam, wali kulli qawmin warith, that has existed, that still exists into the times in which we live, that have only increased in severity in the times in which we live, and the warnings of each of these groups of deviation. The warnings of each of these groups of deviation. They brought us what is Islam and what is not Islam. They brought us that which gives us tafasil. It gives us details as regards our religion. So that we're not confused. So that we're not confused. And when the scholars of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they refute the groups of innovation, they say, لِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ وَارِثٍ, that every group has an inheritor. Someone who inherits their deviance from them or their guidance from them. If a group of people are deviant, then there is a group of people who inherit their deviance from them. If there's a group of people that is guided, there's a group of people who inherit their guidance from them. Up until the Qiyamah Sa'ah, up until the last day, all of them ordered me as regards and instructed me as regards the Jama'ah. Unity with the Muslims where? Unity with the Muslims in their hearts as regards their belief and their understandings. That they were all working for the good of their community. As Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, هذا ونصر الدين فرض واجب لا للكفاية بل على العيان باليد وإما باللسان وإن عجزت فبالتوجه والدعاء بجنان. He said that supporting the religion of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, which is the intention of every Muslim, or must be the intention of every Muslim, it is something that is fardun wajib. It is something that is an obligatory duty. Upon who? Upon just some people to support the religion. La lil kifayati bal ala al-ayani. He said in the end of his nuniyah, not upon some of the people as a community obligation, that if some of them do, then the others don't have to do. But rather it is the responsibility of every single Muslim to support the religion of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, to support the call of the truth with whatever they have at their disposal of resources. لَا لِلْكِفَايَةِ بَلْ عَلَى الْعَيَانِ بِالْيَدْ وَإِمَّا بِلِسَانِ وَإِنْ عَجَزْتَ. Either you support it with your hand, with your wealth, with your strength, with your energy, with your skills, or either with your tongue if you have knowledge to speak with the truth, to call to the truth, to order the good. Forbid the evil is an obligation upon every Muslim to order the good. Forbid the evil, call to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and give advice according to the degree of their knowledge. Not to talk about things that they don't know, but to speak about that which is clear. To speak about that which is known, to advise each other for the sake of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and so in defense of the religion of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَإِنْ عَجَزْتَ. And if you don't have anything that you can do with your hands, and if you can't order the good, forbid the evil with your tongue, فَبِالتَوَجُّهُ, then the least that you could do is direct your heart towards the good. Pursue the good with your heart. Pursue guidance with your heart. Let Allah know from you that you want the khair, that you want guidance, that you want good for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but and even much rather you want good for the entirety of the creation of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, more than they want it for themselves. Let Allah know that from you. فَبِالتَوَجُّهِ وَدُعَ بِجَنَانِ. And make dua sincerely from your heart. And make dua sincerely for your heart. كُلُّهُمْ يَأْمُرُونَنِي فِي الْجَمَاءَ. All of them order me with the jama'ah. Order me to stick close to the community of the believers. To be united with the Muslims. Where? Be united as regards our beliefs and our understanding. Be united as regards our intention. All of us wanting to support the religion of Allah and make it the uppermost in the earth of Allah. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. Support. Or be united with the Muslims rather as regards our ibadah. As regards how we worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, that we worship Allah as the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed us. Be united with the Muslims as regards their buldan, as regards the lands in which you live. The person who has the ability financially to leave the lands of disbelief and go to the lands of Islam. This is from the meanings of al-jama'ah, the scholars say. It is from the meanings of al-jama'ah, to live alongside the Muslims, to take your children out of a cesspool of filth, a cesspool of confusion, the harms of the media, the harms of the entertainment industry, the harms of the education system, the harms that are found even in those lands because of globalism and because of technology and so on and so forth, spreading filth and poison to the ends of the earth. At least in those places, bi-idhnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, you will have more of a chance. You will have more of a chance to find the people of khair. Do your homework first, though. You have more chance to find the people of goodness, to find the people that can teach you your religion, find the people that you can learn the Arabic language from, find the people that you can learn the Quran from, find the people that you can learn the correct beliefs from in the likes of these affairs. All of them ordered me with the jama'ah. وَنَاهَوْنِي عَنْ أَصْحَابِ الْأَهْوَاءِ. And all of them warned me against the people of innovation. All of them warn me as regards the people of innovation. Thumma baka, Baqiyat ibn al-Walid, he said, and then Thabit ibn Ajlan, he started to cry after he said this. And it was an emotional thing. Thabit ibn Ajlan had accepted Islam and he had traveled to the ends of the earth meeting the scholars of Islam. And he had given us a concise advice. And if I was to tell you one thing that I learned from all these scholars, the greatest imams that ever lived, if I was to give you one thing that I learned from them, they advised me to stick close to the Muslims and be united upon the truth. And they warned me against those people that introduce things into the religion of Allah with false interpretations that are not from the religion of Allah. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. Thumma baka. And then he cried. He said, ما من عمل أرجع ولا أوثق عندي من مشي إلى هذا المسجد يعني مسجد الباب. He said, there is not an action that I feel more hopeful for. There is not an action that I am more confident about than my walking to this masjid. Meaning the masjid of Bab, the city that is called Bab, is called Bab al-Abwab, the city of Darbend in Azerbaijan. This was before 100 years had passed after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there were Masaajid of the Sunnah in Azerbaijan, in the Caucasus Mountains, the farthest reaches of the Caucasus Mountains in the north, past Constantinople. How could he not cry? How could he not weep? And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has spread this religion in a way that no other community of people have been successful in spreading their religion before in less than 100 years. There is no action that I feel more confident about than my walking to this masjid, meaning to be with my brothers, to learn beneficial knowledge, to get those things that I mentioned in the hadith of a brother I can be of a benefit for, to find any words of wisdom and guidance, and to find the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala.